So how can educational technology tools be improved using AI research? One of the concerns that I have around AI is who's developing and creating the artificial intelligence component, because intelligence, if it's not defined as multi-dynamic, will really miss opportunities to support diverse types of student engagements. And so for me, AI has to be informed by perspectives that value and understand students' culture, that can provide examples that empower students by speaking to their context and their identity. And so if AI is designed in ways with intention to empower diverse communities, it can support diverse learning. The challenge is we need design teams that reflect diverse perspectives in order to make sure that the software that is developed really can empower every student. When we think about educational technology, we have the opportunity to represent people, culture, context, phenomenon. AI can do that work. There's a real power that AI can provide representations that were almost too costly for educational technology developers to use before. So for example, I would have had to pay a graphic designer to create a VR environment. And so now for students, if I ask them about the carbon cycle and how we want to follow the carbon cycle, it is a really complicated thing because you have to envision this huge scale. And there's two things that are powerful about this. First, that I'm able to do this by simply typing in a queue, and now the students can take a look at a 360 and see how gas exchange is happening. More importantly, I can embed cues. And so we picked an artist, Bad Bunny, and we created music and sounds and to help the students get a sense of connection. So part of what we want to do is use the technology to improve the digital representation and then embed cultural cues in the design. So AI really makes it a lot easier for us to create educational technology that's really rooted in students' culture.